So the topic is standardization of recipe. So if you search in Google by the name of the dish, you can find that for a particular dish there are different recipes out there. Okay, so or if you find in a food production handbook, then you can find that every handbook have their own recipe for a particular dish. So which one is, question is, which one is perfect or which one is the standard? The answer is everything is standard. It depends upon you that what you will choose. So for a establishment or for a hotel or restaurant, an executive chef or executive sous chef choose these standard recipes, okay, and apply it for the establishment. And every staff should maintain the recipe when every time when he make this dish or many dish make this particular food. Okay, so now we have to know what are the components of a standard recipe should have. First thing, recipe title. So recipe, the particular recipe have the own title, name of the dish, recipe category, which type of dish. Maybe it's a recipe of dessert, recipe of main course, recipe of snacks. Now ingredients, they have to mention the proper quantity, weight and the proper name of the ingredients we need to make the dish. Next, preparation instruction, and they have to mention how to prepare this food by those ingredients. Next, cooking temperature and time, and they have to mention the particular cooking temperature or for a baked dish particular baking temperature or of a dish, of the dish, and they have to mention the time, how long we cook. Okay, next, serving size. They have to mention the portion size. Okay, like it's the dish for 4 people, for 10 people, they have to mention the size of portion size of the dish. Okay, next, recipe yield means what is the actual size we gain from the dish. Okay, actual nutrients or maybe actual size we gain from the dish compared to the ingredients, that is recipe yield. Okay, what are the actual size we gain from the dish, that is recipe yield. They have to mention this. What are the nutrients? Okay, they have to mention what are the nutrients, what are the what are the quantity of the nutrients we gain from the dish. Okay, and last thing is equipments and utensils to be used. What are the utensils and what are the equipments we need to make this dish? Okay, they have to mention this. So these things, recipe title, recipe category, ingredients, weight and volume of the ingredient, each ingredients, preparation instructions, okay, cooking temperature and time, serving size, recipe yield, equipments and utensils to be used. Okay, we have to mention this when we standardize a recipe. Okay, standardized recipe, if you follow a standard recipe every time, so what will be the advantages? First thing is consistent food quantity. Okay, so if you follow a standard recipe, at that time everything is fixed, your ingredients, your quantity of ingredients, volume of ingredients, everything is fixed. So when you make a dish again and again, every time when you make this dish, the food quantity will be same, just because of ingredient quantities are also same. Second thing is predictable yield. Yield means the actual size you gain from a dish, okay, compared to the ingredients. So when the ingredients are consistent, at that time you can easily predict the actual size or actual nutrients you gain from the dish. Customer satisfaction. Suppose you have a restaurant, okay, and once a customer come and eat a particular food from your restaurant, after few days this customer again come with his family and need this particular dish in its particular taste. So what we will do, if you follow, if you maintain a standard recipe, you can easily make this dish as its previous taste. Okay, so it's impress the customer, it's helpful for customer satisfaction. Next thing is consistent nutrient content. When the ingredients are same, then nutrient contents are also same, because nutrients are found from the ingredients. Next thing is food cost control. So you know the quantity of the ingredient, you know the size of the ingredients, you know the what are the ingredients you need. Okay, so at that time, if you know the number of the customer or number of the consumption of the guest, okay, at that time you can easily maintain your food cost. Next thing is inventory control. Inventory control means keep a record of your inventory, like your ingredients, okay, your equipments. So you need a record of your inventory. In a standard recipe, everything is fixed. Okay, when everything is fixed, your ingredients are fixed, your equipments are fixed, then it is very easy to keep a record of your inventory. Next thing is labor cost control. When a chef make a dish again and again, then he will be skilled for this particular dish. Okay, at that time your labor cost or your training of labor cost will be reduced. Next thing is increased employee confidence. Okay, when a chef or when your staffs or employees are skilled, at that time they gain their confidence. Okay, so it will be very helpful for your establishment. Next thing is reduce record keeping. Just like I say, if everything is fixed, if you know the actual size of the ingredients, if you know the what are the requirement of the particular dish, okay, then you don't need the extra things. So at that time it will be very easy to keep a record of the ingredients, maybe equipments. Okay, and the last thing is wastage control. When wastage happens, okay, when you don't know what will be the ingredients you need, what will be the quantity of the ingredients you need, at that time you just keep the extra ingredients, at that time wastage happens. But if you follow or if you maintain a standard recipe, at that time everything is fixed and you know the actual quantity of the ingredients you need. Okay, you know the actual required quantity of the ingredients, at that time wastage will be zero or maybe in a few quantity. Okay.